My name is Andy O'Neill, and in this co-build tip video, I'm going to show you how to run a scenario on the last day of the month. Now, this is a common challenge with make. Let's say you have reports that you want to run the last day of the month. There's really no option for scheduling. When you go to scheduling, there's no last day of the month option. So what I've done here for starters is I've selected days of the month. So that's when I want to run the scenario. And this is going to work for running it once on that day. I've got noon chosen here. And then right down here, I can select the days. And I've selected all of the possible lengths of months on the calendar. So 28 for February, except for leap year, and it's 29. And then you have months that are 30 and 31 days long. So this is only going to run on those days of the month each month. So it's not running all month long and wasting operations. Okay, so I'm going to show you the filter I use to make sure that this only runs on the actual last day of the month. So I have a filter here, and let me open this up a little bit. And I've got a format date here that says when this runs, so whatever the current date and time is that this runs, tell me what the month name is. So I've got four M's here, four capital M's. And if we go over to our tokens for date time formatting, you can see that four capital M's gives you the month spelled out. So for example, if this runs now, our result for here would be November. You can see on my calendar, it is November 19th. So, and then I have another one here that's the same thing, except I'm adding a day. So I've got my add days here. So I'm saying whatever the date and time it is now, add one day. So this is going to give me the date of tomorrow. And then I'm going to format the date as the month, just like I did up here. So what this is going to do, and I actually have these formulas set up in this first module here. So I'm going to just run this to show you what the result is. So today's month is November, and tomorrow's month is also November. November 20th is also the month of November. The way this works is in our filter is when these don't match. So this scenario runs on November 30th and says, calculate today's month. Well, today's month is going to be November. And then it says, add a day to today and tell me what month it is. The next day is going to be December. That's when we want to run this scenario, when today's month doesn't match tomorrow's month. And that's what this filter does right here. So it says, format the date. What is today's month? Today's month is November. And then add a day and tell me what the month is, and it's December. So when November is not equal to December, then we are on the last day of the month. This filter is going to let this scenario run. So let me go show you an example in my history. I purposely ran this on October 31st. Here's October 31st, and you can see today is October, tomorrow is November. So you can see our filter went through and this module ran. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.